Hey, I'm Nixie Pixel and you're watching OS Alt, your source for open source. Many of you have watched my tutorial on how to install Ubuntu and asked a lot of questions about partitioning. You want to know what they are, how big they should be, and what file systems to use, and how to resize them, especially if you're going to be dual booting. This seems like a lot of info, but don't worry, I'll try to make it painless for you. Brought to you by JackThreads. First, let's talk a little bit about file systems. Without a file system, your hard drive is useless. It's the file system that organizes and enables your operating system to store data on your drives.
File systems are much like paper filing systems, sometimes also complete with indexes, and can provide different features such as encryption, data protection and recovery, or bad sector allocation. Some common file systems are FAT32 or NTFS in Windows, HFS Plus in Mac, and EXT3 or 4 in Linux. When formatting a drive, you usually have your option as to which supported file system to use.
So you have your hard drive formatted with a file system and ready to go. You don't have to use it as one big chunk of storage. Sometimes it's better to separate it into smaller pieces.
Partitions are the smaller, usable sections of a hard drive that your computer can see as separate drives. Windows Disk Management, Mac's Disk Utility, and Linux's gpartite are common examples of partitioning applications. It's often useful to put your system on one partition and your data on another. For this Ubuntu 12.04 installation, I use three partitions, one called root for the operating system, represented by a slash, one called home, where user data will be stored, and one swap partition. Your swap size should be at least as large as the size of your RAM, especially if you intend to hibernate the computer. With Ubuntu, you usually want a larger home partition, and one benefit of separating root and home is that if you want to upgrade, you can just install the new system on the root partition, saving your data on home and avoiding running an upgrade script.
Say your hard drive is half full of data, but you're unhappy with Windows and want to try out something new, cool, and free, like Linux. You don't want to move or lose your data, but you need some free space. Here are several different ways you can do that.
The way to free up space from your drive or partition is to open Disk Management in Windows and choose Shrink Volume. In Mac OS X Lion, you can open Disk Utility, choose Partition, and Resize Partition. In Linux, gpartite will do the same thing after choosing your device, the partition menu, and then resize, move. If you're having difficulty, it's often easier to boot from a live CD or USB, because many utilities can't change partitions that you've booted from or have currently mounted. Once you've freed up some space, create your new partition, format it with a file system, and then you're ready to go.
640K ought to be enough for anybody. Bill Gates, 1981. I hope this helps you see that working with hard drives doesn't have to be so, well, hard. Thanks for watching OS Alt. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss next Friday's episode of All Things Open Source. Now a message from our sponsors. If you love alternative apparel brands like American Apparel but hate wasting all your cash on them, listen up. You can score these premium brands at up to 80% off every day. There's a new invite-only shopping club just for guys called JackThreads, serving up brand names at prices that will melt your brain. There's a wait list to join, but if you head over to jackthreads.com/OSALT, you'll get free instant access to all the killer hookups.